All right, hey everyone, it's Inferno Canuck back with episode 3 and more. All right, so first things first, one of the viewers, Crocive, C-R-O-C-V-E, suggested that I build a sewers and a dock, one to help with the population and the other one to help with trade, get some income, and not really focus militarily. It's great advice, I'm going to do that. Obviously, though, I'm still going to go for Eretria, because it's a big, fat, juicy target, and Leonidas and his brave 480 are going to be taking that place. Alright, I think I'm all done on this turn. Let's just quickly double-check here. All my characters are moving around. That's good. My one settlement. Oh, yes, my diplomat and my spy. Well, let's keep on exploring the big, wide world. Let's see here. Oh, okay. Looks like the Macedonians just have one territory. I realized something, though. I'm wondering if I want to get an alliance with anything just yet, before they start bordering me and start looking at me with big, greedy eyes. No, not yet. We'll see how things play out. I'm going to just keep my diplomat pretty close around this area and just go as it does. So let's just quickly talk to the... Okay, alright, you can hurry up. There we go. We don't need trade rights yet. Let's give this a shot. Let's see if they have any more map information for me that I can possibly buy. Okay, yeah, they want to trade, but I don't need to trade yet. We don't have any sort of trade route. Like I said before, it'll just tick them off in the long run. Alright, let's offer them just a little bit more and see if they take the bait. No, we cannot offer anything in return. So I can, what I can see is what's already there. Now, oh, great. He lost a little bit of experience by having that negative deal. I'll just have to be a little more careful in the future. Okay, so it looks like we have other diplomats hanging around here. This is a little diplomat party, so in the next turns I'll be learning about the surrounding area. Alright, let's end this turn. Okay, and he's doing his thing. Alrighty. Alright, so first things first, let's see what's going on. My shrine to Demeter has been completed. Which is good. See, it has lowered my population growth. Now, let's see here. We have a choice between a port, which is for 4 turns and 800, and a sewers, which is for 4 turns and 800. I'm going to go with the sewers. As you can see, the health bonus is going to help not only my public order, but also the population growth rate. So we'll do that. Leonidas got married to Aether. Well, that's nice. I'm sure he will celebrate it by killing somebody. And, oh, I'm only negative 19 now. Only negative 19. Negative... Okay, well, 845. I just spent something, but as they say, you gotta spend money to make money. And, frankly, I'm going to, I think I'm gonna be A-okay. So, let's land in the, fishing village of these... rebels? Eretrian rebels? Okay, so they're not quite as weak as I thought. Oh, hey, I'm blockading it. But, but their other army's way on the other side there. Okay, well, I'm gonna siege the town. I have enough. I only probably will need one ram. So, we'll maintain that siege. Now, there's a chance that these guys will attack me while I'm sieging. If they, maybe they can't even get to that side. If they can't get to that side, I'll have a bit of an advantage. We'll see. You know what? We're going to go with a secondary plan, though. We're going to move my boat back up the coast here. And so the secondary plan is as follows. I'm going to take a diplomat, my diplomat here. I'm going to put him on this boat. And next turn, I'm going to bring them over here. I'm going to try to bribe these guys. And if I can have enough coin to bribe them properly, they may want to just join with me. I won't have to fight anybody. I'll be kind of poor, but it'll be worth it in the long run, I think. Or I might just fight them. God, you guys probably need an actual battle video for a change. So I might do the Spartan way and not be some sort of wuss and actually, you know, fight them. All right, what else we have going on here? As you can see, I'm pretty dead even when it comes to oligarchy versus monarchy. The neighboring regions are monarchists, so that's kind of messing me up a bit. Also, what happens is when you leave a character inside a settlement for one full turn without them moving at all, you get these little gatherings. This one is an oligarchist gathering. A group of very influential people are convinced that they are able to manage this settlement very efficiently. Would they be in the power to do so? If the government believes in the management skills, he will undoubtedly accept oligarchic leadership soon. And that allows me to build a new building type, which is a government building type. And this is going to give experience for my troops, and it's going to up my oligarchy conversion rate, which I will be doing soon. But first things first, stabilize the economy. Now I know what Barack Obama is under the pressure, even though I have a feeling he's not going to be invading Eritrea anytime soon. Alright, we'll just double check with my agents. I think I have a spy here. Yeah, he's not doing anything. Okie dokie. He's just going to check things out. Oh, there's Pyronia. That's nice. And, oh, no, whatever. That was just some diplomat. Alright. Let's end the turn. Okay, oh, and the Athenians are expanding as well. Good to know. Oh, and they got their asses kicked. Oh, hey, this answers my question. Alright, so we have a pretty dead even force. I think Leonidas is going to push the way. Oh my god. I have hoplites. Dorikoi hoplodi, which are hoplite warriors. And cavalry. Now, thankfully. Oh boy. Okay. Well, this might be an interesting battle. No, let's not auto-resolve. Let's fight this sucker on the battle map. Okay. When a cat wants to eat her kittens, she says they look like mice. My cat was talking. If I had a cat, I'd be more worried about her calling her kittens mice than, you know. Oh. Uh-huh. That's a lie. I was totally seeking war. Okay, well, this is interesting. I would have thought that, Oh, good, they're watching us, so they can watch us get slaughtered. Woohoo! Alright, enough of this. Now, this is a little bit of an interesting deal. I would have just assumed that, just like in vanilla Rome Total War, all general units are cavalry. Well, that's not the case here. As befitting of a Spartan, he's not on some stupid gay-ass horse. He is a member of a strong fighting force. These are what I'm going to be using to fend off the hoplites, while my javelin men and archers kind of pelt them from around. That's the plan, at least. I'm going to need, frankly, I'm against very strong armor topic. Foes, I'm going to need every advantage I can possibly get, which means I'm climbing the hill.